What's up, guys? My name is Robert Donaldson, and with everything going on with the Iowa football program right now, it's possible that you might have missed that the Hawkeyes have just added another grad transfer from the Northern Illinois Huskies football program, and once again, it's a defensive lineman, and this time it's coming in the form of fourth-year senior Matt Lorbeck. Earlier this offseason, the Hawks added a different NIU defensive lineman via grad transfer in the form of redshirt senior Jack Heflin, and if y'all haven't seen the video I made on him yet, you can check it out on YouTube or on blackheartgoldpants.com. But for a little bit of background on Lorbeck, he originally played his ball at Bayport High School in Green Bay, Wisconsin, and coming out of high school, Lorbeck was listed at 6'3", 220 pounds, with his designation being at inside linebacker, despite going on to spend the majority of his snaps at NIU on the edge. In comparison to Heflin, Lorbeck is a very different kind of defensive lineman, and being listed at 6'4", 255 pounds coming into Iowa, his body type profiles more as a 4-3 defensive end or a stand-up edge rusher in sub packages, and that was essentially his role at NIU as well over the past 2 years, outside of some occasional snaps at inside linebacker. So, essentially, Lorbeck will be coming into Iowa looking to compete for reps at defensive end, and there's obviously now a void at the weak side defensive end spot opposite Chauncey Golston now that AJ Epenesa has moved on to the NFL. So now that we know that Lorbeck is coming in at a position of need, the question now becomes, how good is he? And what kind of skill set is he bringing to the table? And just looking at his numbers during his three seasons at NIU, Lorbeck recorded 62 tackles, 12 tackles for loss, 5.5 sacks, and 4 forced fumbles. And those numbers might not necessarily jump off the page, but in context, Lorbeck was playing behind two quality veteran players in the form of Sutton Smith and Josh Corcoran for a couple years, which obviously limited his snaps. And with that said, from a measurement and talent standpoint, comparing Lorbeck to a guy like AJ Epenesa doesn't make really a whole lot of sense because they're built very differently and stylistically, they win off the edge in very different ways. In comparison to someone like AJ Epenesa or even a Jack Heflin, for example, something that really stands out with those two guys is their hand usage and their technique as pass rushers and two gappers, and those two things would be areas that I wouldn't consider strength with Lorbeck's game at this point in time, as right now he's more of an edge-bending speed rusher who tries to win around the edge with pure straight-line speed rather than a good combination of good hands and speed. And with Lorbeck, when he would face good offensive tackles with good feet, he'd end up getting washed out of a lot of plays due to his inability to consistently counter when his initial speed rush gets stopped. In addition, Lorbeck's lack of good hand usage and length can rear its ugly head when blockers attempt to drive him off the ball, and also when he attempts to work off blocks. And his lack of length also shows up from time to time in the form of missed tackle opportunities. With that said, Lorbeck does possess some good athleticism, and it shows up in his lateral quickness when sidestepping blockers, crashing on run plays, and also in his ability to quickly recover off of cut blocks. And I think that's the biggest takeaway you should have when you look at this addition, because his athleticism is definitely up to par with other Power 5 defensive ends who have similar frames, and when you combine that with his Division 1 playing experience, it's easy to see why a team like Iowa would be willing to take a chance on him, especially when you consider how thin they are at defensive end right now. You know, it'll be really interesting to see whether or not Lorbeck ends up redshirting this fall to work on some of the subtleties of his game that I was talking about, or if he's given an opportunity right away to step in and compete for reps. And if the latter ends up being the case, I'm just not sure how impactful he's going to be right out of the gate, and there'll certainly be a lot of growing pains as he adapts to Big Ten play while working on his hand usage and ability to counter. And personally, I would love to see Lorbeck take a redshirt year, because there's a lot of times when I'm watching him play that he really reminds me of a former Hawkeye defensive end named Nate Meyer, who was a very good player during his tenure and a guy who definitely gave the Hawks a big boost on defense during the Rose Bowl stretch back in 2015. And as of right now, Lorbeck comes across more as an interesting short-term project player in need of some refinement more than an immediate plug-and-play guy like Jack Heflin, for example. I want to thank y'all for checking out today's video, and if you have any questions, comments, or ideas for future videos, feel free to comment wherever you're seeing this, or you can tweet me at RobDFB, and I'll definitely be able to see it. With all that said, I will see you all in a future video. Take it easy.